Here we are, 3 days before the end of the current fiscal year, and that June 30 budget deadline has crept up on us very quickly. There's been an incredible flurry of activity over the last 6 months here in the Senate, but our number one responsibility as legislators is to approve an operating budget each and every year. And here we are, debating whether or not to support House Bill 790, the General Appropriations Act for the 2019-2020 fiscal year. Mr. President, it's quite simple. There are over 33 billion reasons to oppose this bill. There are over 33 billion reasons to support this bill. In my brief but eventful tenure as a House member and now in the Senate, I have yet to see the perfect budget. I'm sure those who have been here much longer than me can say there is no such thing as a perfect budget. It's true. And I'm sure with most in this chamber, there are things that you like and things that you don't like about this general appropriations bill. I approach my vote today with two key questions. One, is this budget respectful to the taxpayers, the people who pay our bills? And two, does the good outweigh the bad with this bill? There are a lot of factors that went into this year's final budget. Our state's revenues are exceeding expectation, thanks in part to the decisions that we've made over the years to avoid joining other states in the Northeast to hike broad-based taxes. Plus, we've made a concerted effort to pay our bills and meet our obligations. And finally, with great gratitude to the strength of the federal economy over the last 2 years that has lifted our state's financial outlook. I agree with many of my colleagues that there is more work to be done on a lot of issues and many reforms. But let's look at House Bill 790. This budget includes $300 million that will go into our rainy day fund. This budget increases year-over-year spending by only 1.8% when you count the governor's supplemental spending. Yes, we fund all of the services that our constituents who we represent have come to expect. We have made historic investments in our next generation, including basic education, special education, higher education at proven institutions, as well as record investments into grants for students. We're continuing our commitment to strengthening and making our schools safe. Mr. President, specifically, this bill adds $8 million to assist high medicated populated nursing homes all over my district and the Commonwealth. It provides a 2% rate increase for home care workers and personal care assistants because we know that people want to be in their homes. And it includes a 20% increase in funding for services for the disability, for the visually disabled. All of this and more without raising taxes on the hardworking Pennsylvanians who pay our bills. Yes, there are things that we would love to see added or maybe even removed from this budget from both sides. But Mr. President, that's why, while many of us look at this as the end of a fiscal year, we need to look at this as the start of the opportunity to address future reforms to our budgetary process come July 1. There are a lot of people asking us, please support this, or add this, or oppose that, or subtract this. I don't disagree, but we are moving a $33.9 billion budget today. And tomorrow, you better believe, we're going to be pushing out new reforms to this process. We all know, Mr. President, that our economy is cyclical. Will it get better? Will it get worse? We don't know. I've often said that the two things I've always wished that I've had in this building is a crystal ball and a magic wand. But what I do know is that we must do everything in our power to ensure that Pennsylvania is in the best position to take full advantage of what we are seeing at the federal level and experiencing to an extent here in the Commonwealth, And that starts with our decision today. Holding the line on spending, providing critical services, putting away $300 million into the rainy day fund, I commend our leaders and the staff who crafted this budget. This budget exercises the right mix of fiscal restraint with impactful investments that are critical, not for today or tomorrow, but for years down the road. We have a lot of work to do, Mr. President, and we may adjourn for the summer in the next few days, but today I will be casting an affirmative vote for House Bill 790. And I say, let's get to work, because the people of Pennsylvania deserve that, and the next generation is counting on us to fund what works. Thank you, Mr. President.